In this video, we'll show you how to set up Elgato Prompter with a webcam or smartphone, including mounting onto your setup, attaching your camera to Prompter, and the basics of control through Elgato Camera Hub. First, here's what comes with your Prompter. Prompter with the integrated 9-inch display, an L bracket for mounting cameras, a backplate for use with Facecam Pro, a ring backplate used for attaching Prompter directly to the front of a lens. Additionally, 9 step-up rings which attach to your lens, a universal backplate with a shroud for use with any camera, a braided USB 3.0 Type-A to Type-C cable with a special 90-degree connector, a cleaning cloth, and a quick start guide. Now, time to mount Prompter in your setup. This could be on master mount on your desk, master mount on a weighted base, a tripod, or even Wave Mic Arm LP, which is really nice. You have a lot of flexibility. Prompter has 2 quarter-20 thread mounting points. In general, you will be wanting to use this one further towards the back for the best balance. We'll begin by showing Prompter with master mount. When connecting Prompter to a master mount, instead of spinning the entire assembly to thread it on, try this. Loosen the ball joint on master mount. Hold Prompter up to the screw thread, and then spin the ball mount screw into Prompter. Then, once tight, lock down the ball mount. Now to set up Prompter with a webcam or smartphone. For this, you will need the universal shroud backplate. To change the backplate, find the 2 thumb screws on the top corners. Remove them and set aside. Now you can remove the backplate by tilting out and lifting. When installing a backplate, make note of the tab at the bottom of the backplate, which fits into Prompter like so. Then, reinstall the screws. This backplate has a fabric shroud which is used for blocking light from entering Prompter, and has a large opening for accepting all sorts of cameras. You can use this backplate with a DSLR or mirrorless camera, but if your camera has a threaded lens, you may want to use the ring backplate. We will have the setup guide for that linked down below in the description. You will need to attach your camera to the top side of the L bracket first. The top side has these side sections. To demonstrate, we'll be using Elgato Facecam. First, make sure you have Facecam's monitor mount removed to reveal its quarter-20 thread. Next, screw Facecam onto the top side of the L bracket, but you don't need to fully tighten it quite yet. Attach the L bracket onto Prompter. Before fully tightening, raise or lower the L bracket so that your camera is centered in the opening of the backplate. Once it is centered, tighten down the thumb screw on the L bracket. From here, you will want to bring forward your camera as far as it can go without touching the inside of the beam splitter glass. Then, tighten it down. Be careful with larger cameras which have longer lenses, and avoid bringing them too far forward to where it hits the glass. Now, rest the shroud over your camera to block out any light. Now you're ready to position Prompter and connect everything up. Prompter has 2 cold shoe attachment points on the top 2 front corners. These can be used for attaching lights, microphones, or any other lightweight accessories. Be careful with heavier accessories, as they will place more stress on your mount. Now it's time to connect. Prompter connects to your PC or Mac using an included USB 3.0 cable. The special 90-degree bend on the Type-C connector is handy for neat routing around your setup. You won't need to install any drivers when connecting to a PC. However, for macOS, you will need to have Camera Hub 1.8 or later installed for Prompter to function. When you connect Prompter, it will appear as another monitor with a resolution of 1024 by 600. Be sure to open the display settings of Windows or macOS to reposition Prompter's display to reflect where it is physically in relation to your monitor, up above, to the side, etc. Since Prompter behaves like just another monitor or display on your computer, you can move videos, web browsers, presentations, chat windows, or even games onto the display. We won't tell anyone. Lastly, Camera Hub includes some powerful functions that integrate with Prompter. Inside of Camera Hub, you'll find a new tab on the top left, next to Camera and Effects, called Prompter. Inside of this new tab is all the new features and controls. Here on the right is where you can paste text from your scripts. It can be broken up into sections we call chapters. You can add new chapters by clicking on the plus button here. Using Camera Hub or your Stream Deck, you can jump to specific chapters as needed during use. At the top left, you can control brightness of the display itself. Content type allows you to switch between scrolling text, like from a script, showing chat from a live stream, or display, where prompter behaves like a normal monitor, with no overlays. Below that, you can customize the look of your text, with options such as font type, size, margin, color, background color, and the opacity for both, allowing you to place your script on top of another program like a video call, with your script being partly transparent. At the bottom, you can control scroll speed, and if prompter continues to scroll when reaching a new chapter. Switching to chat mode allows you to see a real-time chat feed of Twitch channels. You can add Twitch channels into Camera Hub and switch between which is shown at the tap of a key on Stream Deck. Prompter pairs perfectly with Stream Deck pedal. Start and stop scrolling, change chapters, and more with the tap of your foot. You're now set up with Prompter and Camera Hub and ready to begin creating. We've also created a video talking all about which cameras can work with Prompter, from field of view and focal length to weight, and even 3D printing your own parts. Links again are in the description. If you need help with your Prompter or with Camera Hub, please reach out to our support team. Or if you have any questions about what we demonstrated in this video, let us know in the comments down below. Subscribe to us here on YouTube to learn how to get the most out of your prompter and other Elgato products. Thanks for watching.